Hello, everybody. Chris Profi, Musically Obsessed. And today I want to enter a contest. And the contest is for Todd Guy, the Thrashing Zombie. I just love that name. Todd Guy, the Thrashing Zombie. He's celebrating 1 year in the VC, so congratulations to Todd Guy, the Thrashing Zombie, for a year in the VC. If you have not checked out his channel, definitely check it out. I'm looking forward myself to watching more and more of his videos. So he's got a contest here. So I figured I'd jump in and tell you, you know, what my answers are and what I came up with. So the first question is, name some bands that you have gotten into because of the VC. So bands that we've heard about because of the VC. The first band is a band called Brand X. And this is their album Livestock. It's a live album. Brand X is a jazz fusion band. Proggy. And they have none other than Phil Collins on drums. And I heard about this through a friend, Anthony Ferraro. He sent it to me as a VCLT. Never heard of these guys before, but, you know, loving Brand X. And like I said, Phil Collins on drums, you can't beat it. Another band that I've gotten into is Cheap Trick. And the reason is because of Emma over at 8 Vinyl Low. She preaches the word of Cheap Trick. And I finally bought an album. And this was the first one I bought, Dream Police. And I love it. So thank you to Emma. I never really gave Cheap Trick a chance. I've told this story before, but I know of The Flame, the song The Flame from the 80s. But I never really got into them. So, you know, now I've got Dream Police. I've got the first album. I've got Live at Budokan. So definitely becoming a Cheap Trick fan. So thank you, Emma at 8 Vinyl Low for that. Another band, Renaissance. This is their album, Scheherazade and Other Stories. This came out in 1975. I heard about Renaissance through Bill over at the Vinylverse. Never heard of them before. I actually never heard of them before either. They're a prog rock band with some classical influences, classical music influences. So very cool stuff. Never heard of them before. So thank you to Bill over at Vinylverse. Check out Renaissance if you like proggy classical music. Very cool stuff. And the last one I'm going to show you is a death metal band called Blood Incantation. And I heard about these guys through Pete Pardo over at Sea of Tranquility. Very cool band. This album came out. When did this come out? Of course, now I can't find the year. I want to say in the last couple of years this came out. Blood Incantation. Who are they? They're a death metal band, but they mix in prog with their music. So just really cool stuff. I love the themes on this album. It's all about aliens and ancient aliens, and I'm just into that kind of stuff. So you mix the aliens and the prog rock and the death metal. These guys rock. Blood Incantation. Thank you to Pete Pardo over at Sea of Tranquility. Now, number two, question number two, an album that we were not sure we liked at first. Well, this is a little band called Mofungo. And this is their album Out of Line. It came out in the 80s. And this came out on the Zor 13 label. Here's the back cover. Unique band. I heard about these guys because they also released some albums on the SST label. This is, of course, not on the SST label. So I got the album, and at first, listen, there was so much going on, I wasn't really sure what I thought. There was some punk influences. There's some art rock in here. A little bit of Talking Heads. I heard some Camper Van Beethoven. Some world music, some jazz. It was kind of all of this stuff. So it was a lot to digest in first listen. And I wasn't sure how I felt about it at first, but loving Mofungo right now. I've got their SST releases on CD, and I'd like to get more of their stuff. So if you are into any of those influences that I just mentioned, Talking Heads, Art Rock, Camper Van Beethoven, world music, jazz. You might want to check out Mofongo, real cool band. But again, I wasn't sure what I thought about them at first. Now, question three kind of goes along with that. An album that gets better after repeat listening. So the Mofongo album, I feel like gets better. Another album, and I've shown this before, this is one of my favorite bands, Black Flag. Actually wearing the shirt today too. This is their instrumental album called The Process of Weeding Out. And it contains four jazzy punk instrumentals that are sort of meandering and heavy and just heady. And you just really need, this is one of those albums you need to put headphones on and just listen to it, just totally get into it. And at first, some of the songs might even seem like noise to the untrained ear, but the more you listen to it, those melodies start to come out. The guitar riffs start to come out. Little snippets of melody and ideas start to come out. And every time I listen to this album, I hear something a little bit different. I'm like, wow, I didn't recognize that the last time I listened to this album. This is sort of a polarizing album. You either like it or you don't like it. So if you are sort of into what I would say, like if you like later Miles Davis jazz fusion, like his weird, real long, crazy stuff, like from, Big Fun or Get Up With It, you would dig this album, Black Flag's The Process of Weeding Out. So definitely gets better with repeated listenings. All right, question four. The worst cover art. Now, a lot of people have shown the Black Sabbath album Born Again as being the worst cover art. And I've seen a lot of stuff on that Black Sabbath cover, how a lot of people feel like it's a really terrible cover. I think even Todd Guy showed it. I happen to actually like that cover. So, I'm not going to show that. Now, this probably doesn't look as bad at first. But this is Jefferson Starship's album, Earth. I just have never really liked this cover. I think it's kind of cheesy. I really feel like they could have done better. Love Jefferson Starship, but the cover for this, cheesy. Just the font that they use, the fact that there actually is an Earth on there. I don't know, it never grabbed me. I always thought it was kind of cheesy. You know, Jefferson Starship has some great album artwork. I know their album Spitfire has some great stuff on it. This one, not so much. Sorry, Jefferson Starship. The music is awesome. Cover, not really. And best cover art. I wanted to kind of show two different albums that I don't think I talk about too much. I was really going to pick an Iron Maiden album because that would have been real easy. Somewhere in Time, awesome cover. Killers, awesome cover. Power Slave, and actually any Iron Maiden cover. So I went out of the box a little bit here. The first one I want to show is Lou Reed, The Blue Mask. I've always loved this cover. It's so striking and simple. And there's Lou Reed there. Just a great cover. I've always liked it. It's simple, but it's striking. I can imagine like walking through a record store and seeing this on the shelf and going, yeah, I want to try that out. That looks really cool. So for me, I think this is a really cool album cover. The other one, a band called Crocus, and this is their album Metal Rendezvous. How awesome is that cover? Two cars just crashing into each other. I'm picturing like a demolition derby. I just always thought this cover was really cool. Excuse me. It kind of shows you what you're going to be hearing inside Crocus, which is, they're just a great hard rock band. Overlooked a lot because they're a lot of times looked at as almost like an AC/DC ripoff, but they're not, believe me. Crocus has a lot more to offer. They're a great band, and love the cover, Metal Rendezvous. So that's the questions. Congratulations again to Todd Guy, the Thrashing Zombie. I know he's gonna spend many, many more years in the VC showing us many, many more great videos. And if you haven't checked him out, definitely head on over to the channel and check it out. Listen, enjoy the rest of your Monday, and you know what? Listen to Blood Incantation. Adios.